Dan, we've had a wet week
just
so far on Sunday, but we actually had a little tornado scare on Saturday.
Right, yeah. The two different warnings back on Saturday morning, Todd. The first one was before that one got to the Des Moines metro area, about in Polk County. There was one up in Story County. This one has been confirmed now here. So let's show you the radar image first. This is between about 5:45 and 6 o'clock in the morning up to the north of Ames right near Gilbert, where you can see that kind of bluish patch on the, this is the wind data from the radar, that blue color next to that green color. Basically, that's wind moving faster towards the radar than that little spot next to it. And that's where you would induce a little bit of a swirling motion. That's likely where this tornado would have formed. And now we have some satellite data to kind of give us a little bit closer look as well. So this is from the European Space Agency's Sentinel satellite. It's a little bit hard to make out because this is a little tornado. But there's Gilbert right there. So Highway 69 coming out of Ames is right here. And then this is a little subdivision called Buck Hill, a few miles west of town. And then if you make out very faintly, you see that line I'm tracing? It kind of disappears and then reappears going through the cropland, goes to the southwest side of Gilbert, and then there's that kind of patchiness right here where the tornado kind of washes out, gusts out, and it just some straight line winds. If I were to animate it, you might be able to make it out a little bit better. But the red lines kind of trace the path very faintly northwest to south and east of that tornado back early on Saturday morning. Obviously did some crop damage, blew a few signs over, caused some tree damage and everything else on the southwest side of town, but that's the latest on that.